Hey, this is Ray Dombrowski from the Vector Lab. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make seamless pattern repeats. The reason you may want to do this is if you're designing prints for apparel, such as board shorts or woven shirts, something like wallpaper that's printed out on a roll of paper, or a background pattern for web, or just a pattern fill for your graphics. So typically I start with a square background and I lay out all the elements, and the main key here is you want it to repeat side to side, top to bottom. So what I'll do is select the elements that hang over on the left side, and I'll hold down my Option key to drag a copy. And as soon as you see it snap, just let go and you know that it's in the correct position. And the same thing for the bottom. I'll just drag a copy up. And the reason I drag up the background with the elements is so I can see that the corners of the background snap. And I'll just go ahead and delete that. So now what I do is select that square. And usually I want the background separate. So I'll go Command C and then I'll lock that, Command 2. And then Command F to paste in front. And I hit Command 7 and that creates a clipping mask. And now I unlock the background, and just to check the repeat, I'll drag a copy to the right and then I'll drag one directly up just to make sure everything looks good. And that looks really good. There's not too much of a repetitiveness to it. Sometimes you'll get elements that are clustered together, and when you see the print from farther away, you'll notice more of a obvious repeat. And typically you don't want that. You want it to look kind of seamless where you can't tell where it stops and starts. So if you want to use this pattern repeat in Illustrator, what you can do is just select that part that's clipped out, not the background. And in your Pathfinder menu, hit the Merge button. And that basically takes all the vector points that are clipped out. It takes those away. So now you can select the whole thing, group it, and then just drag it into your swatches palette. And now it's a pattern fill. And you can take any shape and just like you're filling it with a color, you can fill it with that pattern. And you can even fill type with these patterns. So now you know how to create a seamless pattern repeat. Be sure to check out thevectorlab.com where you can get a free download of Graphic Design Launch Kit.